StreamerBot explained. Actions and subactions. Actions and subactions are the way you tell StreamerBot what you want it to do. Actions are the name of a set of instructions, and subactions are the individual instructions. You might find it easier to think of it like baking a cake. You have a cake recipe, the action, and then you have the steps, adding flour, eggs, etc. The subactions. This concept, along with the triggers, is the core logic of how StreamerBot works. Thankfully, this is all in one place. If we navigate to the Actions tab, we will see on the left we have our actions, and on the right we have our subactions and triggers. So let's talk about actions. Actions are what you will trigger with whichever method you choose. Action names must be unique, and each action can be placed into a group. Groups allow you to disable and enable actions quickly and in bulk, and it keeps them organized. Now, let's create an action. Right click and press add. And for the sake of this video, we're just going to call it demo. We'll leave the group for now, but the additional settings here are concurrent. This means all the subactions will run at the same time, as opposed to the general top to bottom. Always run. This means the action will still run even if the queue is paused. Exclude from history means it won't show up in the action history. Finally, random action. This means it will do one of the subactions randomly, which can be influenced by wait. Wait is a way to leverage the possibility of a subaction being selected when using random. These can also be found in the Actions context menu. Now, if we move to the subactions window, we right click here, and here is where we will add our subactions. As explained before, they are the instructions, and each one of them has their own way to set up, so be sure to check over the documentation for more help. They range from doing stuff in OBS, to interacting with Twitch, and working alongside some of our integrations. At the time of recording, there are over 220 different types of subactions. Subactions can be individually enabled and disabled. They can also be put into a group and work on a random with waiting, like it's been before. If we go into the Actions Queue tab, we will see pending actions, action history. You'll also see queues, but that's a whole different video. Pending actions will show the actions that are currently being run or are queued to run. This is the best place to come if you need to help debugging something that's getting hung up. Action history will show you the actions that have run. You'll also be able to see the variables here, and that is also handy if you wish to debug something. But with all this information in mind, you should now be able to create your own actions and subactions, and know the difference. Thank you for watching. If you have any other questions or need any more assistance, please feel free to reach out in Discord. Link for that is in the description. Also, you can check out some of these other videos to teach you more about Streamer.bot.